and welcome to this week's Movie Math, where at first, we couldn't believe what was happening in the movie industry. No movies able to open? No theaters able to be open? Everything on streaming? Oh look, Universal and AMC are fighting. This is crazy. But now, shit's starting to get real, because the industry finds itself in what's becoming an unbearable holding pattern. There's no answers. People don't know. They don't even know when these movies are gonna maybe open. That's how up in the air things are. And I think the biggest question mark is, what are moviegoers going to do? And that's an answer we won't get until the theaters actually do reopen and a movie actually takes the risk of opening in this uncertain environment. Oh, it's crazy. It's crazy. So yes, all eyes are on Warner Brothers, who has been the studio to step up to say, we'll save the entire movie industry and maybe sacrifice a giant movie in the process. We'll see. So of course I'm talking about Tenet. Will it open July 17th? Some of you pointed to a tweet from AMC. Social media accounts are like the lowest on the totem pole at a movie company. For instance, AT&T likes to tweet out and get you guys all excited about the air cut. It's not like the head of AT&T or the head of AMC are like in constant contact with the head of the social media people who run those accounts. I mean, maybe they might sometimes give them directives like make everybody happy, right? Or get everybody excited about HBO Max, or in this case, get everyone excited about returning to theaters. But AMC just tweeted that out because AMC really needs Tenet to open on July 17th. They admitted this week, which we're going to discuss, that they might not be able to stay in business. Wall Street was saying that before, but this past week, AMC was like, it's true. So again, will Tenet open July 17th? How down to the wire is Warner Brothers going to get when it comes to making this decision? Variety said they'd make a concrete decision weeks ago when they decided to start their campaign up again. But Warner Brothers was like, oh, I don't think so. They started their campaign up again, but didn't put an official date on the trailers because they're keeping their options open, which they should. And now there are some rumors that you guys have tweeted me today that, you know, some very like obscure outlets are saying there might be a decision this week. The truth of the matter is there could be a decision at any time between now and I would say the beginning of July. I think that's how much time Warner Brothers has to decide, because they do have the option of pushing Wonder Woman 1984 and giving that date to Tenet. Who knows what else will happen to the release schedule? We'll find out when Warner Brothers makes this decision. There are a lot of movies and dates in play. But I think that they really do have till the beginning of July to make the call. Because while this pandemic has twisted our perception of time, how appropriate, for, you know, considering Tenet's the first movie up, the reality is that July 17th is actually 6 weeks away. That's really far away. So that's also making the movie theaters sweat. They're not going to get a big blockbuster for another 6 weeks. Meanwhile, Disney is putting two of their big movies on Disney Plus, and they're not getting any heat for it because it's not premium video on demand. So Disney isn't making any money off of the movies specifically. That's the loophole that they're using. And they could decide to do the same with Mulan, as I told you when this pandemic started, and then I recently heard that, you know, Mulan is once again being discussed as a PVOD release. That's when Disney will cross the line, and we'll see what movie theater owners say at that point. I suspect they'll be miffed, but Disney's going to have to do what Disney's going to have to do. Also, they are, I think, going to throw New Mutants as a bone to theater owners, because Disney doesn't really care about that movie. They're not going to continue with that universe. You know, the Dark Phoenix was like just such a write-off, you know, it's just such a disaster for them. I think they're kind of resigned to the fact that New Mutants will, well, I think New Mutants could, I don't know. I think New Mutants has a very strong, small group that's interested in it, but I think most people probably will be like, this story isn't continuing, I'm not going to go see it, and certainly I'm not going to risk my life, so it's kind of mean to do that to the people who are really excited about it. Well, we'll see what happens, but I think New Mutants will probably open at the end of August in theaters. We'll see. All right, so anyway, when movies first return, whatever that might be, as you can see, it's going to be a trickle rather than a steady stream, at least through the end of summer. Because we basically lost summer 2020 as a movie season. For the first time ever. That's insane. It's the most lucrative time of the year for movie going. It's followed, I believe, by the holiday movie season. But summer's 3 months. It's the biggest movie going season, and it's just gone. And it's going to be gone for a while. In fact, Cinemark's CEO, as he gets ready to reopen his theater chain, has said this past week that he doesn't see movie going returning to where it was pre-coronavirus until 2022. 2022! That's so bad. which means it could take until then to get another billion-dollar movie at the box office. We just had 9 of them in 2019. That was a new record. And we're going to go down to 0 for not only 2020, but 2021 as well? That's real bad. I mean, the Hollywood will have to lean on digital like they've never leaned on them before. And they were starting to lean pretty heavily. All the new streaming services that have just launched, it's not, I think, I predict that HBO Max gets rebranded. We'll see. But the way it's going, I predict it gets rebranded with Warner Brothers. You know, there's no shame in it. I would do it. I would do it sooner rather than later. While everyone's distracted, I'd be like, oh, look, it's now Warner Brothers themed. But anyway, I also feel, as I've been telling you for weeks now, that they'll shorten the theatrical window during this, at least probably for the rest of this year. I wouldn't be surprised. I think shortening it to 2 weeks would be, I think theater owners would just riot. It would be devastating. But I think they could shorten it to a month. I really do. I don't think they'll do day and date. I don't think they'll do day and date, because that also would be just devastating for movie theaters. And Hollywood is running out of content for any platform, theatrical or streaming. In fact, this past week, just as theme parks have pushed to reopen, and they are reopening with substantially limited capacity, we still don't know how they're going to do from a business perspective in the United States. Universal just opened. Disney World isn't opening until mid-July. And the rules are crazy. They're like, just because you have a reservation at the resort doesn't mean you're necessarily going to get into the park. It's crazy. And Disneyland still doesn't have a confirmed date of return. But Universal, the movie studio, is leading the charge this past week to get production started again, submitting their own guidelines on how to proceed. But once they get greenlit by the government, the unions in Hollywood still have to weigh in. And all productions will be much slower. They're going to like bring people in groups. They'll be like, first you come in and you set up the set with production and set design. Then the lighting team will come in and they're going to light it. And then only the actors and the camera people will come in and film it. Oh, this just sounds crazy to me. I think it's going to be super slow and a lot more expensive. And it was expensive to make this stuff before, right? Don't be surprised if no new productions start up under these new guidelines, but they're really just used to finish productions that were put on pause. For instance, Universal has Jurassic World Dominion. They already started filming. They want to finish that movie for next year. So I think that that's probably what everybody's interested in doing. They want to finish WandaVision. They want to finish Falcon and Winter Soldier. As we've been discussing, and some of you have suggested, they might finish those shows stateside. I think it might be a while before you have any overseas shooting. I don't know what the Batman's going to do with its London production. But yeah, I think they want to finish the movies that they began, at least, to get those underway. New productions? I don't know about that. Now back to AMC Theaters. This week the company sounded the alarm itself, saying there was substantial doubt, their words, that they could stay in business even after reopening, because they've had no revenue for 3 months, and now another month, basically, until Tenet maybe arrives. And it's put them over $2 billion in debt. And they were doing so good before all of this. They were a company that was having some, you know, they were staying alive, but the books were a little bit dicey. And then when they do reopen, they'll have substantially limited capacity, substantially limited product, and also their concession stand revenue should be way down because, of course, most people will be wearing masks. It's going to be tricky. It's going to be very, very difficult. Now, I don't think, as I said before, that AMC theaters will go away forever. But if they buckle too early, this is a wrinkle because I can't see anyone wanting to buy the chain at this point in the timeline, because it would be losing money for perhaps the next couple of months. If they can't hold on to, like, say, the end of the year, who would want to throw more money after bad? And I don't know, I would think they could just shutter for someone to purchase later on, but how would you keep the places open? They have to file for bankruptcy first, and that might buy them some time, but they won't be able to pay any of their leases, their rental fees. So that's going to be very difficult. But if AMC does shutter, that will take over 8,000 screens in the United States offline and 11,000 screens across the globe, including the 8,000 in the United States. But that's a lot of screens where these movies that are trying to come back won't be able to play. So I think maybe that's one of the reasons AMC said this. They were like, save us, Obi-Wan Kenobi, whatever in this metaphor, whoever that is. I'm not even sure who Obi-Wan Kenobi is in this metaphor, but you're our only hope. Because they're like, we're circling the drain and we're taking 8,000 United States screens and 11,000 worldwide screens with us. And that's bad. Now, as of June 1st, as you can see from this lovely map from Variety, thank you, Variety, about half of the country still won't allow movie theaters to open in terms of states. It's like 26 states, I believe. including the biggest movie markets, New York and California. New York City starts phase one tomorrow. Although Mayor Bill de Blasio clarified, I thought it was every 2 weeks. People have been saying it takes about 2 weeks to go through stages. But Bill de Blasio said because of the nature of New York City and how crowded it is here, we probably won't get to phase two until the early July. And we're not going to see movie theaters open until phase four. So they will not be ready in time for Tenet, even potentially with the August opening date. I can't see any movie opening, by the way, if New York City isn't in play. I know a lot of you are like, it's only New York City, Grace. It's the biggest movie market city-wise in the country, if not the world. I think it has to be in play. I mean, also China, the second, you know, China and the United States are almost in some ways tied now as movie markets. China does not have a set date of return for its movie theaters either. If Tenet does stay on track, at this point, I believe it would be a sacrifice on the part of Warner Brothers and Nolan for the good of the movie industry, including theaters. What do you think Tenet should do? Like, realistically. I mean, there's what you think Tenet should do as a moviegoer, but what do you think it should do from a business perspective? I'm not sure even myself. I think a movie theater, I mean, to sacrifice Tenet, though, it's an expensive movie to sacrifice. I'd be like, move up New Mutants, I guess. I don't know. I mean, it's really crazy. I do think it should move to August, though. I feel pretty strongly about that. So what's everybody watching this week? Oh, it's tough out there. All right, so even on streaming. So on iTunes, it's really good, though. This is wonderful to see the current global discussion about racism, and it's so wonderful that it has turned into a global discussion reflected in the top 20. And that's because of some pricing that was also done on the service to their credit and to the studios who are behind these movies. Harriet! I recommended it myself this week. It's a fabulous film that you should watch. Great story of African-American history, fantastic talent in front of and behind the camera. Totally worthy of your time. It's on sale. It's only $7.99 to buy, $5.99 to rent. Everyone's checking it out. I'm so happy. So happy. I was so sad that more people didn't see it in theaters. Waves, also doing well, is a 99-cent rental. And Queen and Slim is also on sale at the same price point as Harriet, at $7.99 to purchase. Just Mercy is free. It's free. And it's doing pretty well. It's not doing great, but it's doing pretty well. And there are other, by the way, you should check out iTunes. They have a number of movies that are actually free right now on the same, covering the same topic. Although Just Mercy is the only one that was able to make it in the top 20. Trolls is also having a sale. It's now just $15 to rent, but get this, for 30 days, not just for 48 hours. And so that's gotten back up into the top 10. And then there are two European or Eastern Europe, well, you know, foreign films that are doing quite well. Villain is from the UK. That came out actually 2 weeks ago, but it's a very good price point. $4.99 to buy, $6.99 to rent. People are checking that out. And then also The Blackout. This is a Russian movie, but it has an English dub. It's $12.99 to buy, $4.99 to rent. I checked out the trailer. Pretty good VFX. And I think it's funny that in this story, because, you know, the movies always reflect the country in which they're made, only Russia has survived an alien or some kind of other world invasion. I love it! Over on Netflix, The Help got a similar boost from the discussion that's going on right now. That's a great movie. 13 Reasons Why, though, final season, unseated Space Force already. At least Space Force is still number two. Space Force, there's no second season greenlit just yet. Doesn't seem to be doing as well as Upload. That's a real shame. I'm curious, why do you think Space Force didn't work out? The Last Days of American Crime, which is a movie, that's doing pretty well on Netflix, a new movie just started on Friday. And also Queer Eye is doing pretty good with its fifth season, which also just debuted. Then over on Disney Plus, already some Percy Jackson love as one of those films hits the streaming service. And Schoolhouse Rock, it's a non-Disney property, is trending on the Disney service. That just hit as well. It's shorts, very short segments, like 4 minutes, but they have like 50 of them that just hit the streaming service, which is fantastic. It also proves that Disney Plus is still largely used as a babysitter streaming service. Interestingly enough, what's doing best on HBO Max? Looney Tunes, probably for the same reasons. Also, many of you said that Jessie continues to be so popular on Disney Plus because it's become a TikTok sensation. I believe the lead actress has. Now, as for this coming week, iTunes is badly in need of some studio content. And they're getting it on Friday with Universal's The King of Staten Island. That's right. They've already got movie theaters on the ropes from Trolls World Tour, and they're hitting them again with The King of Staten Island. I saw the movie last week. The embargo lifts tomorrow at noon, and my review will be going up at that time. Then on Friday, and I believe King of Staten Island is a Friday release, even though usually movies hit iTunes on Tuesday. But also on Friday, Artemis Fowl finally hits Disney Plus, and we'll be doing a watch-along party on Friday evening. I still have to set the time. And then also Spike Lee's To Five Bloods, an awards contender, will debut on Netflix as well. Which of those three movies do you plan to watch over the weekend? And you can watch all three, or, you know, a combination of them. I think they all will probably do a lot of business. So share your thoughts on all of this crazy stuff that's going on down below. Subscribe today. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.